Hey everyone, PCIe Express is great because it allows us to expand our computer's capability beyond what our CPU and our motherboard offers us. Want to do proper PC gaming? We'll buy a graphics card and put it in our x16 slot. Well, maybe not this GPU since it's ancient, but you get my point. In my case, I wanted 10 gigabit Ethernet, so I purchased an Intel card that requires an x8 slot. There's one problem though. Barely any motherboards actually have x8 slots. So can you fit a shorter device like an X1, X4 or X8 card into an X16 PCI Express slot on your motherboard? Also, can you fit a larger X8 or X16 PCI Express device into a smaller X1 slot, for example? Well, I'll answer these exact questions in this video, firstly covering can you physically do this, and secondly, is it a good idea to do this? Let's start with the easiest case first. If you have a shorter PCI Express card like an X1 Wi-Fi card or a X8 10 gig card, can you fit one of these into your motherboard's longer slots, such as an X16 slot, which is often used for graphics cards? Well, yes, you can. It will physically fit fine. The PCI Express specification allows for this to happen too, meaning you should never have a case where the notches on an X8 card won't physically fit into an X16 slot. Equally, an X1 card can fit into any PCI Express slot, of course, and an X4 card can easily fit into an X8 or X16 slot. This should also never be a major performance hit from doing this either, although I'll discuss this point more in a minute. So we know that going bigger will always work. Awesome, but what about the other way around when you have an X8 or an X16 card, for example, but your motherboard only has a spare X1 or X4 slot? Well, this is where it gets a bit tricky. The PCI Express spec says that this should also be allowed, meaning you could buy some awesome new RTX 4090 and plug it into an X1 slot. That should work fine, even though it would massively limit the bandwidth down, of course. Equally, my X8 Ethernet card should fit into X1 and X4 slots based on the general specification. However, some manufacturers use close-ended PCI Express slots included on my Asus motherboard for this computer. This means that I actually can't physically fit an X4, X8 or X16 card into my X1 slot. The plastic at the end actually physically stops this from happening. In this case, we have two options. We could either buy an X1 to X16 riser cable, for example, or we could physically cut the closed end plastic off like Iron Ring Tech Haven briefly did. Fair play to them. Both the options will then allow you to fit a larger PCI Express card into a smaller slot, with one exception. Some manufacturers layout their boards badly. For example, my Asus motherboard has an NVMe slot right next to the X1 slot. So even if I hacked all the plastic off the end, still wouldn't be able to fit my X8 card into it, and so I'd need to buy a riser cable even then. Okay, so we now know that you can fit a wrong size PCI Express device into different slots, but should we do this? Well, the various PCI Express designations like X1 or X8 refers to how many lanes of bandwidth a PCI Express card can take up. So if you were to take a powerful graphics card, not this one, and plug it into an X1 slot, you're cutting its available bandwidth down by a factor of 16. That naturally isn't good, because you'll get less rendering performance when playing computer games. Equally, the X1 to X16 riser cables that I mentioned earlier don't magically give you an extra 15 lanes of PCI Express bandwidth. You're just gaining the ability to physically plug an X1 card into an X1 slot, essentially. The card will still be throttled down to the available bandwidth of the X1 slot. On the other hand, putting a smaller PCI Express card into a larger slot should be fine, but there's one exception to all of this that's worth knowing about. Some motherboards might have various X16 slots, for example, but not all of the pins are actually connected up on the motherboard. So you might see a motherboard with two X16 slots, for example, but if you then look at the detailed specs, only one of the slots runs at X16, the other one runs at X4. Basically, the extra X16 slot allows you to just physically fit all sizes of PCI Express cards, but its max bandwidth limited down to a quarter, down to X4 speeds. This might still be fine for some PCI Express cards, such as SATA expansion cards, because SATA drives don't typically run fast enough to exhaust the X4 bandwidth, for example, but it's worth bearing this in mind. This brings me on to the final point of my video. PCI Express slots supply different speeds based on the generation or the version of PCI Express that the motherboard and the CPU supports. The latest Gen 5 PCI Express version is pretty fast, with even an X1 slot giving 4 gigabits of bandwidth a second. This is often sufficient for many NVMe SSDs and will certainly be fine for supporting 10 gigabit Ethernet too. You will, however, still be limited by the PCI Express version, especially of the card. For example, I can't take my PCI Express Gen 2 card that requires up to 4 gigabits per second of bandwidth and stick it in a Gen 5 X1 slot. It'll still only run at Gen 2 speeds, and then it'll be throttled down because it's in an X1 slot. So it's a bit of a confusing topic, but I hope this all made sense. If it didn't though, please drop me a comment if you had any further questions, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.